outside game breaker, knocks it out of his hand up against the ball. It'll belong to the Bulldogs. Storm looks to inbounds, gets it into Bachler. Bachler needs some help, goes back inside, hit by Rinker out of bounds as they tried to get it to one. Now Coach Nieberg, he says, let's try something different this time. Bulldogs were fortunate that one wasn't turned over. Storm this time gets it into Phillips. Inside the boot, Shrew layup gets it into Shuler. 2-0, Bulldogs on top on a wide basket. 7 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Weatherall has it. Holds high, gets it on the right side. Moffitt back on the side, goes to Duncan. Duncan leads it to Shuler. Shuler back past the Weatherall. It's inside, nothing there. Back out to Rinker. Fires the three. Rinker shoots. Tipped out of the right line. Taken by Phillips. Phillips with the rebound. Hustles it down court for the Bulldogs and loses it. Our score. St. Anthony with the lead. The Comets with the basketball. 6:25 to go in the opening quarter. Duncan has it. Lux goes left side to Rinker. Bill Rinker leaves it now with Moffitt. Greg Moffitt flips it over to Shuler. Shuler needs to hit some threes for the Comets tonight. Pass underneath to Rinker. Shot put up. No good. Rebound Boucher. Rinker's it out to Chris Bachler brings it down court for St. Anthony. Leaves it out front with Ryan. Inside, they go to Bouchou, kicks it back out to Storm. Storm down the paint, off balance shot, no good. The first quarter. 5:50 to go in the first quarter. 2-0, St. Anthony, low scoring. There's a collision. Richard blows a whistle, and he's talking to Duncan and Wine because they were kind of pushing on each other before the inbounds pass came in. So Stan Richard says, guys, that's enough of that. All right, Shuler looks to get it inbound. Going in on a 5-second count, and a traveling penalty move from the spot where he was given the basketball. You have to stand still in certain situations. Shuler moves a little bit, and the official moment for the win. That's two common turnovers. It's 2-0. St. Anthony's at one basket. Here's a bottle for three. It's no good. And we got a push underneath on St. Anthony. So Ryan picks up his first foul. Three on St. Anthony. Bulldogs second turnover. So 5-1. 5-1. 5-1, not 4-1. So Ryan, I thought he was unhappy with the whistle when the whistle blew. So Mike Ryan picks up the first foul. 2-0. St. Anthony leads. We've had a lot of smoke and no fire as far as the blocks go. Duncan has a knock away. Storm steals it. Storm drives down for St. Anthony, takes it to the hole, and got fouled on the way to the basket. I think it's on Mr. Rinker.
They're the two that made contact. I think that's a good call. Stoos draws his first foul.
Storm underneath. Alley-oops to Bachler. Bachler in trouble, kicks it out to Wines. He shoots a three, and it's good. A 5-point lead at 5-0. There's a travel. Off the tip of the bench for about 5 minutes. Turnover number four on the top. Four turnovers, just two shots. Bulldogs have made two out of how many attempts?
Out of six already.
So not a lot of shots early in this game. Too many turnovers, steals, and et cetera happening. Wines another three. Good.
Sure.
So delicious, always special.
Real often.
2 minutes to go in the first quarter. It's 12-6. The lob to across the paint, leads it to Schuler down the paint, up on a runner, bounces out, no good. Rebound goes to the Bulldogs. They dominated the backboard there in the early going.
Lockler brings it down to St. Anthony. Still on the dribble, goes right side. Stops, moves it, flips it out to Stoll. Stoll drives, leads it to Bushu. Out in front to Phillips. Out of box, move. Fobbers with a minute to go in the first quarter. Deeper, you would walk in the other way. Drawing a double team, although only somebody open is Bushu. He goes for the layup. And he got it. First, common foul. It'll be St. Anthony's ball under the basket, and Brandon Weber will do the honors. As soon as Mr. Moffitt gets his shoe tied, he does, and we're ready to go.
19-10, St. Anthony. There's the play in for Phillips. He's on the inbound pass. He lost his man on the switch. Got open for the layup. Phillips has four, and the Bulldogs back to an 11-point lead at 21-10. Ranger for three. Top of the key. Out. No good. Rebound Phillips. Yes. One shot for the Bulldogs. That's been about it. Yeah, they only have four rebounds in the game. Oh, my. Matt Seymour is in trouble. He got it out to Mockler. Top of the key. There's a long three by Mockler. No good. Rebound Phillips. Starts to put it up. Gets a step. Feeds it over to Weber. Weber clears it out for St. Anthony, and the Bulldogs set up the offense. They get it to Mockler. Decide to go to Seymour. Seymour on the alley-oop to looking, they go inside to Bachler with it. Bachler's in trouble, back to Weber in the corner. He clears it out, beats it out, goes inside to Phillips for Tabushu. Hook shot, no good. Rebound by the Bobby brings it down across the timeline, flips it off to Rinker. Looks inside, nothing there. Top of the key to Weberall. Decide to go to Shuler. Shuler back out to Rinker. Phil Rinker goes right side, beats inside, stops it. Looks inside, goes to Bushy, back to Bachler for three, in and out, no good, rebound goes to Weberall, back to Shuler, in to Rinker, Rinker shoves it back to Shuler for a three, no good, rebound St. Anthony again, Bachler's got it. Not too good a shooting in this ball game. Out front it goes to Bushy, leads it with Bachler, down the lane, Bachler flips it off to Phillips, he goes to the layup, didn't get it, Bachler on the rebound, puts it out. Draws a double team, needs some help, gets it out to Brandon Weber. Weber has it, looking for some help. Weber penetrates to Phillips, nothing there, and a 5-timeout taken by the Bulldogs. Ron Niebuhr, you don't like the way things are going.
They missed their only three. They missed a foul shot. They had 7 turnovers and just 4 rebounds.
Brandon Weber gets it inbound for St. Anthony, leads it with Bachler. There's a three, it's out, no good. Rebound Weberall. Game by the Comets. Mr. Moffitt with it down in the paint, flips it off to Mr. Cripples. Mr. Cripples is in the ball game. Henry Brooks on my sheet here, a 5'10 junior, number 14. He came in for Brinker. ball game. Three Bulldog turnovers here in the quarter. It still is 21-10. Late in the first half. This is Brooks with it on the side. He needs some help. He shovels it out to Offit. Offit, alley-oops underneath, knocked away, but Wetherill gets it, and he beats on the side. That's a double. Have 2 points in the quarter. St. Anthony has just four.
Bulldogs, I mean, the Comets have had enough trouble turning the ball over. They don't need any help.
Right. Zach Wilson has it, pushes it out, takes it out front, spins it out of trouble, gets it to Wines in the ball game. Mike had a quick eight, and that's where he stands now. Here's Bachler open for a two. Out, no good. Loose ball taken by Bachler. He gets it out front to Bushu. On the side to go to Wilson. Back to Bushu. Spins, turns, can't get it underneath. Bachler.
Off to Wolfman. Wolfman down the paint, back to Bachler. Chris needs some help, goes talk to him sometime before he heads out. I'd hate for him to make the majors this season. We didn't get to talk to him. Maybe we can work that out. Picks up on his third.
Yeah, just got back in the game.
So Brandon Weber's going to come in for him. So Storm playing defense. Didn't get set in time. Picks up his third pound.
I think part of the Bulldog sluggishness in that second quarter was the fact that Stormy wasn't in there. Can't play at all on that. So
Derek
might have been part of it.
Derek's playing time's gone down low these last three or four games. I don't know whether he's not been well or just what's the story, but we've seen a lot more Brandon Weber this last three games.
Weatherall has it for the Comets. Nobody scored yet in the third quarter. Weatherall grabbed it. He pivoted around completely, and the official, Pat McCrone, said he took steps. So it's a turnover on the Comets. They had too many in the first half. They don't need to start doing that early in the second half. But here's the first one. Weber gets it off to Wine. Wine looks for some help. Goes to Phillips. Phillips gets it out front to Wine. Down the paint. Stops off the jumper. Out. No good. Rebound goes to Weatherall. There's a baseball pass to Schiller at midcourt. Gets it over to Moffitt. Moffitt drives. One shot up. No good. Goes down by Weber. Weber picks up his first foul. Second on St. Anthony. You heard all about it here on WKJT, top of the seven game.
With Craig Moffitt looking for his first points of the night, will be at the free throw line. Winner beats D down tomorrow night. Good again by Moffitt. He hit a cone. He's a 79% free throw shooter, so that's not surprising that he makes it. 25-16, a 9-point game. It is at 11. Biggest lead 13 for St. Anthony. White has it. Looks for some help. Goes left side with it. Bounces it inside the Ryan Boucher. He can't shoot. Back out it comes to Weber. Back inside the Boucher. Short jumper. Out. No good. He down.
Bulldogs ball under the basket. Wines will inbound it. 27-21. St. Anthony by by 6, did lead by 13. They get it out to Phillips. Off the line. There's the three.
Anthony by 12.
got a timeout. 30 seconds has four by St. Anthony.
We'll be back.
I believe that was at the half.
That was a halftime score, yes.
Fairfield leads Carmine 30-24. St. Anthony got the basketball.
Bobbitt missed the foul shot. Jansen got the rebound.
He gets it to Storm. Jared Storm on the right side to Jansen. Jansen spins it out of trouble, and there's a reach-in hack. On the court, Chris Schuler. He made sure that one got cold.
The second hack. That's four hacks on the Comets in the half.
He took a real swipe at Jansen that time. 38-26, Bulldogs by 12, have the ball. Storm looking, goes underneath the Jansen layup. Good.
Ball.
who plays Pete down tomorrow night. Bachman's wide open for a three. That was probably set up during the quarter break, and that's 43-30. St. Anthony by 13. You might remember their biggest lead has been 14.
That was the last thing Stu Straws needed. St. Anthony come out in that three.
Underneath for Duncan, shot up, and he got open for the layup, and he's got 43-32. Chris Bachler has it. Spins, right side, back to the left side, flips it off to Eric Jansen.
Quarter stats, St. Anthony 6 of 13 for 46%, didn't go to the line, just one turnover, four rebounds, they made all three of their threes, so that means they were 3 for 10 on their twos. Stu Straws 4 for 10 from the field for 40%, but they had 7 of 8 from behind, just two turnovers, that's worth noting, 7 rebounds, they outboarded St. Anthony that quarter. Stu Straws made their only three.
Jansen and Seymour set down for the Bulldogs, they bring Ryan Bouchou and Doug Wolfman into the lineup. Rinker makes his first free throw, missed his first free throw. His next one's way short. The Federal gets the rebound. And they call the foul on He's got himself a double whistle already with 6:58 to go in the ballgame.
Doug Wolfman's first foul, and that's just shy of Super Bowl Stone's foul. That's 9 fouls.
Here's a free throw by Federal. First one, he's got 13.
Sorry, Larry, I didn't have time to count. I looked up once and it said 9.
All right. Weatherall's next one out of St. Anthony. He's got 14. St. Anthony's lead at one time just a moment ago was 14. Now it's back to 9. They've got the basketball. Brandon Pepper gets it to Boston. Boston goes baseline, rises on a 2, and he got it. Makes it 45-34. Inside to Weatherall, works against Bouchou. Kicks it out front to Cody Rinker. Cody Rinker got an extra step in there, but they say he got an extra step. Wolfman, maybe. You are correct. Oh,
Bachman. His third. I think he was close to the play.
I thought Wolfman was one and did the pushing, but not so standard sharp.
I haven't done as well as these officials several times tonight.
Cody Rinker's free throw is around. That's his first point of the game. Makes it 45-35, a 10-point ball game with 6:29 to go. Next free toss up and in. Cody Rinker makes the ball. He's got two. Phil Rinker back into the ball game. St. Anthony breaks it down. 4:89, 45-36. 6:29 to go in the ball game.
Water boys over there had a collision on the Stu Straws bench. Buddy Clayton Brandt almost got taken out.
The ball got kicked off the foot of Phil Rinker. They had that all kinds of trouble with it in the top and corner. What they were doing there, two of them with the basketball, I don't know.
They'll try it again.
Here he gets it in to Boxer.
Very good question, Larry.
Boxer brings it down to St. Anthony. 6:14 left in our ball game. There's a pass over to Wolfman. Wolfman goes to the hole, drives up, dumps it off to Phillips, and he is fouled on the floor. To Bachler, he goes up and gets it, now brings the back out front. Needs some help, spins, drives, off the glass, no good. Rebound, Phillips puts it in. Aaron Phillips got the rebound on Bachler's twisting missed layup. 47-36, and Dennis Luber wants timeout. Bulldogs lead by 11, we got 5 to the court. We'll see. Anyway, the
gets it on the side to Moffitt. Moffitt beats it out front and away from the player.
Would be this close without him.
Schuler hits again. He's got not one sack in the ball game for the Bulldogs.
Because Strauss has one shot in the quarter, but they've been to the line 8 times already.
Weber goes inside the boot shoot, works against Weatherall, and they found him on the floor. It's a foul on Weatherall. The Bulldogs want to get Weatherall in foul trouble if they can, and that's his third, I believe.
And six on the Comets this half.
Up by 9 with 5:33 to go in the ballgame. Storm gets it in to Weber. Weber has it, spins it out of trouble, gets it to line. He shoots the 3, it's short. And on the air, this is Weber. Raker gets it on the side to Moffitt. Back out to Raker, back to Moffitt. Now they get it to Duncan. Looks underneath. Duncan drives, spins, nothing there, kicks it back on. Nearly loses it. Moffitt saves it. Richard Haney into the ball game. We're going to give Weatherall a breather here with 4:50 left.
I think he wants to tell him something.
To the free throw line, Ryan Boucher, 4 points on the line. 4:50 left in the ball game. Boucher's free throw is no good. Rebound goes to Haney. He clears it out on the side to Schuler. Schuler brings it down. Weber's on it. Schuler has it out top of the key. Needs some help. Goes left side to Raker for the jumper. Good. He's got 4 points. He gets it down court. It's a 7-point ball game. 47-40. Barker getting ready to come back in. Phillips to the hole. Aaron Phillips has it. He gets it to the hole. Nice strong move. 49-40 without Weatherall in there. He was able to make it to the hole. Sitting down is Phil Rinker. All right, it's the common ball. They trail by 9, they got it under their own basket. Schuler looking, has to go deep with it to Weatherall. Luke Weatherall now works against Phillips, takes it all the way to baseline. That jump.
Right there.
Whistle was open for three, but didn't take it. Off to Wise. I think Coach Niebuhr wants to run some time here. Wise down the bank, kicks it off to Phillips. He goes baseline in trouble, fires it out to Phillips. To the Storm, off to Butler. Back to Storm, 2:47 to go in the ball game. Then Anthony up by nine, has the basketball. They get it to Chris Bachler, top of the key. Bachler, off to Mike Line. Back to Bachler. And there's a timeout by Ron Niebuhr. So, 2.5 minutes to go. Storm gets it into Bachler in backcourt. Let's see if the Bulldogs rep some more time or if the Comets are going to foul him and send him to the free throw line.
I don't see him writing anything. I think he's made all the dough he wants to do.
He didn't have to make too many on this one. Line got held by Rinker.
His fourth foul.
So, St. Anthony's going to have to make some free throws in this ball game. Beamer came into the lineup for Bushu during that timeout, and now Beamer steps down and Bushu checks back in. So they want Bushu in there for defense, and they want Beamer in there when they've got it to run the offense, because he's a better ball handler than Bushu is. 2:22 to go in the game. St. Anthony up by nine. White's free throw is good. White's got 18, and he spent a lot of time on the bench. He got eight early. Foul trouble, then he came back and sparked the Bulldogs for three threes and got another foul, and he hits again. 19 points for Mike Line.
I can't imagine who else you'd rather have in the line.
Yeah.
53-42.
Bobble.
Fifteen.
left, the Nation Herald favors a call.
And they give him a call and jump again.
Just let him fight until they wear out.
Gets it inbound, has to bring it up against Bachler's pressure, but he does so, gets it safely across. Minute to go, Bulldogs up by 12. Rinker has it. Rinker forces a three, short, rebound, taken by Weatherall, baseline jumper, short, rebound, Weatherall, baseline jumper. 18 points for Luke Weatherall. Two straws, one for timeout. Bulldog ball under the basket. Phillips looks to get it inbound. He gets it into Bachler. Got held by Montville. Chris shoots the first of two.
But Matt knows what's up. He's just kind of hanging over there by the bench.
Bachler's free throw is out. No good. So Wines missed two, and Bachler misses one here. Now Bush, you're in for Seaver. Bachler with a dozen goes back to the line. 13 points for Bachler and a 56-45 11-point St. Anthony lead with 47 seconds to go. Bushu blocks the shot. Weatherall has the shot got blocked. Thomas want a timeout here. Weatherall's got 20. So they call a timeout again. Let's take a 30-second get it into Wines, and he got held by Cody Rinker. 21 missed a pair a moment ago. This time he puts it up and in. 22 for Mike Wines. Now those three come in, along with Fisher for St. Anthony and for Seaver. Weatherall, Shuler, and Phil Rinker come in. Haney, Phelps, and Cody Rinker sit in. 39 seconds left in this one. 9 seconds off, good. He's got 23. 58-47. Phil Rinker shoots the three. No good. Long rebound. Goes out of bounds. It into Bachler, got knocked out of bounds after it left his hands by Glenn Down. Looking, gets it in finally to Brandon Weber, and he got pushed. Tip off at 7:30, the winner to the Paris sectional next Wednesday night against the winner from Lawrenceville. Free throw up, no good by Brandon Weber, he'll try again. The old switcheroo, they needed the mid pass. 3 for 3. 1 for 1.
I want to see your papers.
How you doing?
I want to see your papers.
Going back and forth across the border here. Brandon Weber makes it. He's got 3 on the night. 59-47. Bulldogs by 12. Phil Rinker gets it off to Cody Rinker. He pulls up, or Shuler rather, pulls up on the 2 and gets it. Seth Shuler's got 11 as he scores. Here's Wines, fouled by Weatherall.
And Luke Smith.
And so Weatherall fouls out with 15 seconds to go. Haney will replace him. Thank you.
bring some more people into the ball game. Andy Rinker in, sitting down is Terry Thomas. Boxer's free toss is good. Now he leads 15 for Boxer. Temple replaces him, and now 5 seconds to go in the ball game. But the Comets bring it down court to get it in to Cody Rinker. And he gets it to back to Rinker. He shoots, no